Do you want to establish a morning routine that'll bring you creative abundance throughout the day? In this video, I'm going to give you tips to help you find your morning routine that'll really set you off on the right foot. And no, I won't be telling you to get up and journal and meditate and read and exercise, etc. It's going to be really what works for you that is the most important thing. I know for a fact that my days feel so much better when I have a solid morning routine and I'm able to accomplish so much before my actual day begins and before anyone else wakes up, just because I have that sense of, okay, I took some time for myself to have self-care and be productive on the things that matter to me most. Hence why this kind of points towards a minimalist morning, because it allows you to clear the space and time so that you can focus on what matters to you. Hey everyone, I'm Jenny. I'm a minimalist mentor and I run Hello Brio, a community of conscious creatives and entrepreneurs. I hope that in this video you can find some tips that'll help you with your morning routine. I'm so excited to be joining the minimalist group again this month, and the theme for June is all about routine. So whether that's a morning routine or a weekly routine or a night routine, etc., the playlist will be in the description, so make sure to check that out too. First, let's get this off the table. Early rise is completely optional and it's also very relevant to your lifestyle. Someone's 5 a.m. might be your 7 a.m., for example. And if you're not a morning person at all, don't try and force it. If you have the ability and the personality to make a morning routine your thing, then absolutely go for it. But if you know it's not you, again, don't force it. Some tips to help you wake up early is that you can set an alarm. And I know that is so cliche. You can put your phone in the other room, etc., blah, blah, blah. But let me show you what I do. I set a haptic on my watch so that I have the ability to get the alarm without waking anybody else up in the room. And I also set a timer on a light in the room so that it lets me know when I need to wake up by. The physical gear up is really important, and I'm not gonna say to do like 20 jumping jacks or something like that. It really just is as simple as chugging a large glass of ice water, and that'll just help wake you up mentally and physically and get you rehydrated and ready for your morning. Coffee or tea is completely optional for your morning routine. As you may know, I'm not doing caffeine anymore. And I actually, when I do have my cup of tea, I do it after my morning routine simply because I don't want to sit there and wait for the tea to steep or the water to boil, etc. So just do what works for you. If you need to have your coffee, then get it set up and get ready to go. But otherwise, it can be completely optional. This part is absolutely key, and it is to avoid any inputs before you sit down to do your work or while you're doing your work. This means do not check your social media, do not check your email. If you can even help it, don't check your phone. Don't even pick up your phone until you absolutely need to. And if you need to reconfigure your settings so that notifications don't pop up on the home screen, or if you even need to turn off your Wi-Fi on your computer, whatever you need to do, just make sure that you're not having any inputs, because that will influence the work that you're doing and make it more reactive instead of proactive, etc. You just want to make sure that this is the time for you to creatively output things. To piggyback off of that, it is crucial to plan the night before. Whether you do this in a digital bullet journal, a sticky note, a regular bullet journal, or a planner, you know, whatever works for you, set an intention and write it down so that you know what you're going to be working on the next morning. Not only will this help you focus on the thing that you want to accomplish in the morning that you wake up, but it'll also help you get out of bed because you'll know exactly what you're going to accomplish that morning. If you want to read the 20 things that I do before I sit down to my 9-to-5, you can head over to my blog. The link will be in the description. I would love to know, what are the things that you do in your morning routine that bring you an abundantly creative morning or help you feel really awesome throughout the rest of the day? Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next week.